So earlier we talked about specializing in a specific area or an industry, right? Now it's important. There are some people that have, some different skill sets. So you might be good at software, but you might also be good at software and e-commerce, for example. So in terms of how you actually organize your own translation memory structure, your own TM structure, it is something that you should, if you can, think about it and how to use it. It is possible to have multiple translation memories. So for example, we have multiple translation memories for each customer that we work with, right? The danger of having one big massive translation memory is that it can fragment. So it loses its value, and it also gets slower as it goes as you grow and you add more text, right? So when you're doing lots and lots of translation, as a translator, the context is also very, very important, right? So translation is not a one-to-one relationship. You can't say, here's a string, there's the translation of it, because it depends on the context, whether it's male, female, multiple, plural. There's lots of different ways of doing things. I talk about in some of my other examples about having a row, right? You can have a row, but that could mean having a row on a boat, or it could mean having a row of bottles, right? So it's the same sentence, but it would have different translations in different languages. So in organizing your TM, Transit, for example, the TM system that we use, has the ability to that you can organize your TM in multiple ways, and it's quite useful for doing different types of translation. So for example, we could have a client TM, and we could have their marketing text together in one bunch. We could have technical translation memory, and then a sort of a general translation memory. So when we come to translate a project for the customer, we can say, okay, look at the marketing text first, the technical text second, and then finally, if you still can't find it, look at the general text, and then it becomes a match then for the translator to do later, right? So if it's possible to do this, certainly it's worthwhile doing it, because the higher focus you have and the more niche you are in terms of your translation skills, the translation memory, the better quality result you will deliver.